every Sunday, I try to start the service by coming up with a conversation that you can have with a friend, a family member. This one is something that you might want to talk about with your son, your daughter, or a friend, or someone who's younger. And the question that's often asked of me is this question right here: why is purity important? And I want to draw your attention to a card I found many years ago. And the card says this about these two elderly people talking, and they said, "Whenever I get mad at you, you never seem to get upset. How do you manage to control your temper?" "I just go to the toilet, go and clean the toilet," the wife said. And he said, "How does that help?" "I use your toothbrush." Now, when you start thinking about purity, one of the first things that some of you are getting freakish right now, but one of the first things that people look at is your toothbrush. You would not even think of or imagine using your toothbrush for any other thing other than your mouth. And sometimes we think about how we allow our brains, our hearts, our physical bodies to take things that are impure and destroy us. And yet a simple matter as a toothbrush, you would never allow it. Because sometimes we don't understand this idea of purity. The other way you can understand purity is by looking at bottled water. You filter that, you try to remove as many of the impurities in it because you know it's harmful for you. Speaking of bottled water, every time I sit in the front row just before I come up here, I drink a bottle of water and I usually peel off the label and wrap it around the other way around. And the reason why is I want to make sure that when I come back down, nobody drank from that thing because I don't want to kiss somebody in the front row's lips. It's purity. It's common sense. You don't want impure things, not just in water, not just in your toothbrush, more specifically in your soul. And finally, one last illustration to bring the point home is scotch tape. When you have scotch tape that's impure, that has all of the lint and all the dust and all the things attached to it, it reduces its capacity to connect to others. That's what happens when we have relationships and we've caused impurity in our lives, in our souls, that now we're unable to stick closer to the people we should have relationships with. A verse that might bring the point home, Ephesians chapter 5, verse 3, "But among you, there must not even be a hint of sexual immorality or any kind of impurity or of greed, because these are improper for God's holy people." The word impurity. And we should not even have a hint of it. Further, he says down in verse 5, "For of this you can be sure, no immoral, impure, or greedy person, such a person is an idolater and has no inheritance, has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ of God." The whole point is impurity causes us not to inherit the great things that God has in store for us. Let's close with a word of prayer. Father, thank you for your holy word. And we ask, Holy Spirit, that you continue to convict, to clarify, to cause us to embrace the purity that you desire for us. You are a holy God, and you desire us to share in that holiness by staying pure and holy before you. We ask this by grace, in the power of Jesus' name. Amen and amen.